I've been to that off, haven't
probably just to carry
this
on
is Brexit.
Trade, race rights, the EU subsidies, they'll stay pretty much the same. And yes, there's no getting out of it. British taxpayers will have to carry on paying the EU bills. But the real crunch point comes after the transition period. And what happens next? Well, that all depends on our politicians and what kind of deal they manage to make. So that's where we are now. Still waiting for politicians to reach a deal. What actually are their options? First, let's look at no deal. If an agreement isn't reached in time, Britain could immediately crash out of the EU with no transition period and end up just using standard international trading rules. In a no deal scenario, British laws would be separated from EU ones, and tariffs and border checks would potentially kick in straight away. Now, it's hard to say exactly what the effect of that will be, but a lot of experts think it would cause chaos across Britain and the EU, warning about economic crash and huge delays at the UK's border. Some people are even saying it could spark food shortages and leave hospitals without medical supplies.
But
remember, these are only predictions of the worst-case scenario. And the government has already made lots of preparations to avoid this kind of crisis. So you probably don't need to hide in a bunker just yet. But there's another problem. Without a trade deal, EU leaders said they'd have no choice but to install a hard border with the UK. Now that would run between Northern Ireland, which is part of the UK, and the Republic of Ireland, which is part
that
of
is
the
for
EU.
You.
Now, to be honest, it's not clear exactly what a hard border would actually look like. Are we talking barriers and police checks and a huge wall along the border? Or could the border just be controlled using technology, with CCTV tracking lorries and cars who cross it? At the moment, we just don't know. But if physical barriers or checkpoints are installed, there's a real risk it could reignite sectarian violence in Northern Ireland. And almost nobody wants that. But all that said, there are some benefits of leaving Europe without a deal, depending on your personal opinion. In particular, it would mean Britain gets immediate control of its borders and can make its own policies on migration. But how about living abroad? Well, for EU citizens already in Britain, the government says they can stay. But under no deal, the EU says there's no specific arrangement to protect Brits living abroad. So that's the no deal scenario. And it's probably no surprise that the British government and the EU both think that not getting a deal could be a nightmare. But some politicians reckon it's looking more and more likely because the negotiations to try and get a deal just aren't going well. So what are the other options? Think of it as a spectrum. Very few politicians, if any, want no deal. But lots of Conservative MPs do want a hard Brexit. Other Tories, plus most of the Labour Party, the SNP and the Lib Dems, they all want a soft Brexit. Meanwhile, the government, well, they're somewhere in the middle, trying to keep both sides happy. So what would these things actually look like?
Mia.
Let's look at hard Brexit. This is what politicians like Jacob Rees-Mogg are calling for. A hard Brexit would see the UK make a definitive split from EU powers. At the moment, Britain's EU membership includes lots of entries. We're not just part of the EU's political system.
Oh,
we're also part of things like the single market, customs union, and the European Court of Justice. Generally speaking, the harder the Brexit, that would mean the government has more freedom to set its own rules and regulations, and it could make trade deals with other countries. As for British business, the impact of hard Brexit all depends on what kind of company we're talking about. It could be good for businesses that only trade in Britain. Imagine you're in Britain and you're selling British apples, but you've got competition, another big apples, and they're grown in France. Now, with hard Brexit, the French apples could get hit by new tariffs and extra inspections as they enter the country. But you wouldn't have any of this because your company isn't taking anything across the border. So this would be bad for their business, but potentially it might mean less competition for you, leaving you to rake up the profits. But if your company relies on trade with the EU, then it's bad news for you as well. For instance, if you build planes and you rely on components from abroad, then you'll be the one taking the hit from all those tariffs and border inspections. How about the Northern Ireland Brexit? Well, it would be tricky to say the least. Supporters of hard Brexit say that physical barriers and police checks still wouldn't be necessary and they could keep peace in Northern Ireland. But even if they're right, some say it could be compatible with EU laws. So the EU might not even agree to this plan. Now, as long as there's some kind of deal with the EU, people's rights to carry on living abroad should be protected. So whether you're a Brit living in Europe or an EU citizen living in the UK, everyone can stay where they are. Anyone who moves to the UK before 2021, unless there are serious criminal or security concerns about them.
most EU citizens will have to apply for settled status in order to guarantee this right. If you're planning on moving abroad, you might have to get this status. After a hard Brexit, complete freedom of movement would end between Britain and the EU. So if you haven't emigrated in time, it might become a lot harder to do so in the future. That's hard Brexit.
That's hardest Brexit ever.
Well, there's definitely plenty of Conservative MPs who would love it. They say that only a genuine break with EU institutions and rules would honour the result of the Brexit vote, restore UK democracy. But there'd also be lots of opposition, including from Labour and Conservative MPs. Plus, the EU would have to agree to it too. So how about a softer Brexit? This option would see much more alignment between the UK and the EU. The softer the Brexit, the fewer things will change. If it was a really soft Brexit, Britain could even stay in the single market. And now for British businesses, this would probably have the opposite effect to a hard Brexit.
Why can't we stay in soft Brexit?
Let's go back to our
I saw us leave Brexit.
A soft Brexit would probably be good for them, because it means no tariffs and minimal disruption. But on the flip side, many British companies, like our Apple seller, would face continuing competition from European rivals. The ability to make new trade deals on its own with places like the United States. Border situation. Well, there might be some changes with things like air travel, no matter what type of Brexit we have. But under soft Brexit, those changes should be very minimal. And depending on the exact type of deal, moving abroad would still be as easy. In Northern Ireland, soft Brexit would mean less demand for a hard border, because most of our trade rules would carry on being aligned with the EU. Looking at this option, you might think it's an easy choice, but it could create political turmoil among people who want to end the EU's grip over the UK. And a lot of people would see it as a betrayal of the EU referendum. You see, although the referendum was technically only about the EU, some people interpret this to include EU institutions, like the single market. Under a soft Brexit, Britain could still be bound by lots of those rules, and supporters of Brexit say that this undermines UK national democracy. All this leaves Theresa May in a difficult situation. She needs the support of as many MPs as possible. So she's come up with a plan that tries to appeal to both sides. It's become known as the Chequers Deal, named after the Prime Minister's country home. Under this scenario, the UK would stay pretty cosy with Europe in a lot of ways. For instance, when it comes to trading goods, the government says it's happy to sign up to a common rulebook with the EU, allowing ongoing harmonisation. In effect, this would basically just be like staying in the EU's single market for goods. It would avoid tariffs and delays at the border. But at the same time, the government also wants a bit more freedom, particularly when it comes to striking new trade deals with other countries around the world. As for Northern Ireland, Theresa May is hoping that if we carry on using lots of EU trade rules, she might be able to avoid a hard border. Hopefully that will stop any potential violence. Under the Chequers deal, everyone would still have their rights protected. So if you're an EU citizen living in the UK, you can stay here. But the government insists it would take control of the UK's immigration policy and end free movement. That's kind of it, in a nutshell, a weird mix of loads of different things. The Chequers deal is basically trying to cherry pick. She wants to keep some things from the EU, but ditch others. Now you might see that as a kind of compromise. But it seems like the EU aren't very happy about it. In fact, their chief negotiator has already dismissed particular proposals, and loads of British MPs from both sides have also criticised it. So things aren't going brilliantly for Theresa May. Okay, so we've seen the four main possibilities for Britain after Brexit. Either we crash out with no deal, or we get a deal for hard Brexit. If not, we could take a... Or finally, we could do Theresa May's plan, or some other kind of compromise. These things could have massively different consequences, and everyone's got their own idea about what would be best. It kind of just depends what your main priorities are. Is it economic stability, control of borders, migration rights, or is it principles about British democracy? Whatever you think, the deadline for making a deal is... Now, if the government runs out of time,
it's wrong.
To a high-risk alternative to avoid a no-deal situation. Either it could try to delay Brexit, or it could call a second referendum and ask the public all over again. Are they happy with the government's Brexit plan? Do people
still... We want to leave Brexit.
Neither of these options would happen without...
Done.
For one thing, Brexit's objective, saying the government is just trying to stop Brexit altogether. And postponing it could open a huge legal and political minefield. For now, politicians are just hoping they agree on a deal.
So it was quite a long time, but hopefully you learned something. Anyway, thanks for watching and hit subscribe to get the latest.
Yeah, please ask that. I'll see you. Bye.